spirit we must show of death, which deals with the world after a nuclear war. And while talking about that, this chapter can be analyzed in three different major segmentalization of the problem. First, pre-war supposition. During nuclear war situation and aftermath of the war. Here we are not talking about any ordinary war, rather we are going to discuss about nuclear war. When we talk about nuclear war, our memory drags us to the year 1945, when humanity was ashamed by two nuclear dogs over cities of Nagasaki and Hiroshima, where two nuclear wars were dropped. The bomb that was dropped on the city of Hiroshima, it released the amount of energy equivalent 20 kilotons of chemical explosive. At the same time, we couldn't forget that memory. When this drop was there, immediately the people came in the range of that. They were able to receive aid or help from outside in terms of medicine, in terms of food supply, in terms of pure water and other supplies. While talking of this, the writer further proceeds to talk the basic point that what is the present nuclear weapon. These two weapons were very small in yield, whereas the nuclear weapon presently there in the arsenal of world, there are 50,000 nuclear weapons. As per the data of 1984, and they are evenly divided between USA and USSR, whereas smaller quantity of nuclear weapons are available with Britain, France and China. Let us remember the fact that this is the data that is unclassified and that was calculated in the year 1984. We must not forget that today India, Pakistan, China and many more other countries, what about North Korea and others, they all are having nuclear weapons. And those countries who deny otherwise, they are also having hideouts and their weapons. And that is why data is not accurate. If we go by guessing it any further, we can notice that this 50,000 can be multiplied into 2, twice, and nuclear weapon may be up to this, crossing the lakhs of the number. But Amalendu Bandyopadhyay talks of 1984 data and he says that if these 50,000 nuclear weapons are exploded, so 20,000 megaton range of energy will be produced. And here, whereas Hiroshima bomb produced 20 kilotons of energy, here 12,000 megaton range, and the impact of 1 megaton range will be spreading over 200 to 600 square kilometers. While the bomb is blast, the immediate fireball will be created and it will be dealing with 200 to 600 square kilometer range, reaching up to the amount at the petrochemicals, other burning fuels, other trees and plants, will make it spread over the 1000 kilometer square kilometer area at the 1 megaton blast. Because if blast is here, all the petrol pumps, you imagine, they will automatically blast. Not only petrol pumps, all gas agencies in the range, and this 200 to 600 square kilometer range, they will, the blast of gas cylinder, the blast of and the burning of wood and other fuel flammable material in 1 megaton range, 1000 square kilometer area will be under its impact. So, and let us see the situation, speculate the situation. Immediate vicinity of the nuclear bomb blast within the tens of millions of, say within the tens of seconds, tens of millions of degrees Celsius, temperature, energy will be produced and temperature will grow up to the level. The low, and that will cause us to speculate the losses in two parameters, local fallout and global fallout. The local fallout will be in the immediate vicinity of the blast, the area which is in its direct impact. And the impact will be more in the downwind direction. If the wind is blowing this way, so the area this side will be more in impact from the center of the blast. And near this, in the downwind direction. When we talk of global fallout, so impacts are analyzed in two ways. Local fallout, people will die because of the blast. Then, because of smoke, suffocation, and in global fallout, who will survive even after the blast and smoke, they will die because of radiation. They will die because of radiation. And then the writer starts looking for the aftermath of the nuclear blast. What is the post-World War? At the blast point, if the blast is near surface or up to the 30 km of range from the Earth's surface, all the blast energy will be mixed in the air. And if it is close to surface, and it is, and the longer the nuclear thermal pulse will be in the air, the less it will be damaging for the life of the people. But if the blast is close to our surface, the blast will be so intense that a crater can be dug inside the ground. And then immediately it will cause a suction of dust into the air, and that will go up to stratosphere. They will stabilize in the stratosphere with carbon material. And this will greatly reduce the sunlight to reach to the ground. Due to this sunlight reduction, first it will create great heat and all that. Global warming will be there, much of the blast energy will be mixed, but after that, global cooling will follow. And we have to remember that sunlight, like if it is greatly reduced to reach to the Earth's surface, then what will happen? Plant photosynthesis is the basis of food chain. Whether we are herbivorous, whether we are carnivorous, whether we are omnivorous, food chain depend, for our food chain we have to depend on plant photosynthesis. And in post-war situation, sunlight is greatly reduced to reach. So photosynthesis will equally reduced in the amount of photosynthesis in the plants will be equally reduced as the amount of light reduced. So it will cause a global cooling. Then there will be severe pollution at the water, food, air, water and food supply. People will die because of air pollution, breathing problems. They will take water, that again polluted water, it will cause death. And then later on, what will happen? The water supply on the surface level like ponds, lakes, they will be, as the water, if stable body of the water, that will be polluted for longer. But lakes, water, river water and reservoir, lake, river and reservoirs, as the water drains out through the system, it will be less polluted. And in the same situation, the underground water may remain unpolluted for years. But once it is polluted, it may take hundreds of years to return back to pre-water condition. Further, the writer says that major challenge, major problem to study such thing is that we have no historical precedent of any nuclear war. Whereas we have single incidents of Nagasaki and Hiroshima at a time there was outside world to help. But this is not a historical example of nuclear war. If multiple blasts over the multiple cities, it is occurring over there, what will happen? That it will totally produce a different qualitative impact on the Earth scenario. And at the time Nagasaki and Hiroshima, there was outside world to help. But in the case of multiple blasts over multiple cities, there will be no outside help. People will be deprived, humanity will be deprived from outside help, as virtually there will be no outside help. Because people from other planet and aliens will not come to provide us medicine and all that. So in such situation, there is a question raised by the author, that will the Earth's climate be permanent? He changed. So not only Earth's climate will be changed, rather the life will be at risk and people will die like anything. Clear? So this will cause death among the people, and maybe because of disease, cancer, mutation, they all will follow in aftermath of the war, and it will cause serious damage to human life, not only human life, animal life, life of existence of flora and fauna, and chances are that the existence of Earth may be deterred or finished. That's it for today. And some poet rightly said, Savan Manushya Yadi Vigyan Hai Talwar, Oise Ne Veg Taj Kar Ho, Smriti Ke Paar, throw it outside your memory, because Kaat Lega Ang, Badi Tikhi Hai Adhaar, Abhi Tu Hai Si So science can destroy instantly if we are not using it judiciously. That's it for today. Thank you.